I'm going to click schedule meeting to book that meeting. And once I do, let's say I want to book a meeting tomorrow at, I don't know, let's say 4 p.m., confirm, it automatically populates my first name, my last name from Messenger, as well as my email that I've provided previously in the chatbot. And so then let's click schedule event, and drum roll please, there we go, the meeting has been booked and confirmed. I can then close this window here, and in Messenger, I'll see all of those details returned to me. Hi there, folks. Andrew here at Chatfuel, and today I am super, super excited to be chatting with you about our brand new Calendly integration, which is going to be a game changer for anyone out there doing lead generation or appointment booking. You are going to love this. It is going to make your life so much easier and ultimately help you increase sales. So that being said, let's jump into Flow Builder here and show you how to get this set up in literally 10 clicks or less. It is ridiculously simple. So here we are in the Chatfuel dashboard. I'm going to click the big plus button up here and choose add from template. Then we'll go down here on the left-hand side to appointment booking. Then I'll click schedule appointments with Calendly, and this will install the template to your account after we click use this template. So basically we've built this out for you already. You just need to customize it or really log into your Calendly account with a couple clicks and you'll be all set. So I'm gonna collapse this side panel over here to give us some more space. And then we can zoom in here to this middle block with the red outline. And that's where we can sign into our Calendly account, which I've already done. And then we'll select the event that we want to allow users in Messenger to book. So here we go, I'm gonna click on this dropdown. I'll say the 30-minute meeting is what we want users to book. And then we're literally all set. Again, it's that simple. So now that we've set it up, let's go test it in the wild and see how it works. So I'm gonna click test this flow down here and we'll take a look on my phone right here. So there we go, the initial message has popped up, and keep in mind, of course, this is all just placeholder text. We can go ahead and customize this later, but I'm going to click schedule meeting to book that meeting. And once I do, let's say I wanna book a meeting tomorrow at, I don't know, let's say 4 p.m., confirm, it automatically populates my first name, my last name from Messenger, as well as my email that I've provided previously in the chatbot. And so then let's click schedule event, and drum roll please, there we go, the meeting has been booked and confirmed. I can then close this window here, and in Messenger, I'll see all of those details returned to me. So again, super simple to set up this Calendly integration to help you drive more leads and ultimately increase sales. So now that we've covered the basics, let's go back into Chatfuel and talk a little bit more about how this works behind the scenes and some more advanced customization that you can do if you want. Again, we just covered the bare bones, the basics, but if you want to take it to the next level, here's how. So in this flow, as I mentioned, you can actually customize all of the text, all of the content here. So as an example, in this first message, if you are not an insurance agent, maybe you're doing real estate, maybe you are a hair salon that's booking appointments, obviously you can customize all of this text as well as the names of the buttons here. Now it's worth noting that these buttons such as schedule meeting and over here on the right side, reschedule and cancel, these aren't typical buttons. These are special Calendly buttons, and you can actually use these anywhere in the Messenger flow, which is really exciting. And what makes them so special is the fact that obviously they lead to Calendly, right? They allow you to perform, or they allow the user to perform certain actions there. So as an example, if I wanted to, down here in this second message where they decide to cancel the event, obviously right now it's just text, but if we wanted to make it more actionable, we could. So maybe even if they cancel the event, we still want to give them the opportunity to reschedule, then we can do just that, and I'll show you how. So I'll click on the text here, we'll click to add a button, I'll click this drop down and choose reschedule Calendly event. Again, I could choose from a number of these events if I wanted to, but I'll choose reschedule since that's most relevant to a user who just canceled the event. And let's type in here reschedule, and we're golden. Keep in mind too, what's really exciting, as I mentioned, is that with the autofill here, you can pre-populate certain fields in the Calendly scheduling form, which I just showed you. So in this case, first name, last name, email. Keep in mind that email by default won't automatically populate if you haven't captured that for the user previously in the bot. So potentially you may want to, before even giving them this schedule meeting button, you may want to capture their email, ask them for their email, save that to an attribute, and then give them the button. Or of course you can just allow them to fill that out natively on the Calendly website instead of in Messenger, but you have the option here to really make this experience of booking as seamless as possible. Now, one other thing to mention here before we end this video is the reminders, right? So this is really cool, really effective. Obviously, we know that some people can schedule meetings and then not show up, and maybe they forgot about it. So if you really want to increase your conversions, increase your show up and attendance rate, then reminders are gonna be critical to your success. So by default, we have a 30-minute reminder, meaning 30 minutes before the actual meeting, the user will receive a reminder in Messenger. And we can see what that looks like right here. If I zoom in, so here we're telling the user, hey, you scheduled the event, here are the details. Again, pretty clear, pretty obvious that you can customize all of this. You can, you know, delete buttons here. Maybe if you don't want to give them the option or even have them think of canceling, you could delete that. And what's really neat as well here is the join button. So basically on the Calendly event that they scheduled, you'll have typically a Zoom link, a Google Hangouts link, etc. You can automatically have that populated in this button. So, you know, 30 minutes, 10 minutes, however long before the meeting starts, the user can just click that link in Messenger. It'll take them to Zoom, Google Hangouts, wherever, so that you can ensure that they'll show up to the meeting. And what's also really cool is you might be asking, well, how does this work with the 24-hour window? Because let's say they schedule a meeting a week from today. How are we able to follow up? Thankfully, as the note says here, we use the confirmed event update tag, which allows you to send these reminders about the event outside of the 24-hour window. So that in essence is the Calendly plugin, the Calendly integration. Again, super simple for you to get up and running with in just a couple clicks, not even minutes, and really easy for you to customize as well. If you have any questions whatsoever, please leave them down below or reach out to us at team@chatfuel.com. So thanks so much for watching, and until next time, happy botting.